Alright YouTube, today we are going to play some Legacy Grixis Delver. It's pretty self-explanatory. I haven't played the deck enough to really know whether or not I should change anything from the sideboard to the main deck. I do like how the deck now plays 7 duels and only 7 fetch lands. It's nice to not get wasted off like double black or, you know, double red, especially when you have these casualties in the sideboard and the Liliana Last Hope. For my sideboard, I took a pretty stock sideboard, and I've only really changed one card. I cut the second piece of artifact removal and added just a Kolaghan's Command, which is artifact removal as well as, like, it's artifact removal as well as a card that just provides a little bit more of a grindy element. So, I'm really happy with this card. I put about 4 leagues, and I totally could see main decking one of these for one of these spell pierces. This card's like a little underwhelming, but again, I'm not really at a place of authority when it comes to that. But let's just jump into it. Play some magic. I enjoy playing this deck. It plays very similar to like a Death Shadow deck. You often have the same roles in a lot of your matchups. Where you're this really weak deck. You're this really, really weak deck here. There's really the lean deck that can be malleable and aggressive. I mean, there's really one land, but you have a force. And it could be better. I mean, we have a brainstorm and a fetch land, so. Okay, this is interesting. Second probe leads me to think that they're not playing a Delver deck. And they're short on me. Something like going to start off by pondering. So I can take a fetch land and then ponder. I can take a fetch land, then I'm not wastelanding them, but it doesn't look like wasteland is going to be the issue here, because they have duress, so they duress my Cabal Ritual. I actually think we need one more piece of interaction. Unless I waste them. If I wasteland them, based on the seed, they can't go duress and ritual in the same turn. So they actually go any order. I don't want any of those cards. We're gonna waste this underground seed. Take the force, right? So I guess I just let him take the force. Okay, did you draw Dark Ritual? They drew a Dark Ritual. Oh, that's a tail. I think that was there though, right? They pondered. Yeah, I guess they pondered. So I was supposed to keep my fetch land. Let me just see if I can learn anything more about their deck before I scoop it up here. Go super dead. So I feel like they're Tez. They're ad nauseum tendrils. Bring in the marsh casualties to fight against Java, what I was talking about, but I don't really know what else to cut. It would have to be the second angler. Excuse me. How good is this angler? I'm gonna get rid of this angler. We only need like one threat to win this game, but it's a death threat shop and Delta or Young Pyromancer. I'm gonna keep this hand because I have a brainstorm. They have a piece of counter magic, I can help fight the red guy, and I have a brainstorm. So I think I'm gonna keep this. And like, we might be able to waste the meta game. It's unlikely, but. I'm probably gonna brainstorm and end the turn. Anything on the stack here, I'm going to search for these. Alright, I'm going to start by pondering. Alright, that's going to be good. So I'm going to waste this. Okay, I think I'm just going to draw a step. They have to have more of them, because if someone's going to look to go for it on turn one, I think they have to just have more in the tank. Okay, so we got one. Sweet. So let's get rid of that. 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 So let's... Okay, so interesting. I think we're going to be able to waste our opponent again here. Unless they fetch a basic island. Picture up over here. Okay, so they did just fetch a basic and they pondered, okay. So now we're gonna hope we draw a fetch land. They shuffled. Okay, so I assume they're looking for black mana. Sucks like waiting until after, like I but I want to hit the land. So I found black mana. Looking for a fetch land. It says everybody that's ever brainstormed. Whoa. That's not too bad. So I guess I'm gonna put back both of these cards, play this wasteland. And then the shaman will at least give me black mana. And if my opponent plays a land, then I'm gonna get him. Just force pitch force on. Maybe that was there. So what am I gonna counter? They'll probably counter the Adnaz. At least we're going to be able to start bringing the Deathrite Shaman down. They probably hold their land, if I had to assume. Yeah, they don't want that thing wasted. Then we're going to have Force Pyroblast up. Or at least one Force Will on Pyroblast up next turn. So I'm trying to think about what I'm forcing. God, it would be so nice to have that pyroblast to smoke something with. So we've done tap here. We're in pretty good shape. Lotus Petal. Okay. So I kind of want to hit the first action. Like, I kind of want to hit. So this is 1, 2, 3 spells. So I think we let this one go. Oh, that killed me. Because, like, oh, this sucks. Because I know he's got at least one more ritual in his top couple cards. So if I let him just keep going off again, then, I'm just doing this to show that I'm not dead. He's going to name force. If I don't counter the first ritual, if I counter the first ritual, then he just has enough gas to go off next turn, and I'm drawing a pyroblast. So we're dead. We're more than likely dead, but we might get lucky here. Maybe they don't go for it. I think that's the only way that I stand a chance here. So if we force this, the first ritual, this next turn. I've almost got three more mana. And they just need a way to empty their hands. The LED kills me. So we're good. Because now they can empty their hand. Get the mana they need, and then go get tendrils. That's frustrating. It's always frustrating losing the storm, because I think I had like the tools to win that matchup, and I likely made a mistake somewhere on my part. On my force. I think I'm gonna force a Deathrite Shaman. My opponent was land Shaman, I think I'm gonna force it. Because, like, I just don't have anything going on against that kind of card right now. Okay, what's up? I'm gonna play with a green deck. I always find these decks hard to play against. two turns off Life from Alone. Then I have one, maybe I'm gonna spell Bears anything. So one, two, four. I can play Angler next turn as long as I get to use this. So I'm gonna spell Pierce anything, and then it's gonna let me get down Dermy down. Solid threat makes it so that I can get around whatever it is, punishing fire, and my opponent is a little ways off of the 2020. Main deck, do they play Caracas in their main deck usually? I'm not sure. Okay, Ghost Quarter. They can Ghost Quarter themselves. So I'm gonna get this in play before my opponent gets priority again and decides to hit my red source. Alright, no plays is good. They're pretty far off the combo here. Deals 2 hit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, so I'm gonna play these out before combat. I really don't want my opponent to like decide to hit one of my lands. And I know I'm playing into this Barbarian Ring, but my hand's on the table. Like, I'm sitting here and we're going all in here. Goes to 9. If my Delver flips next turn and they don't Barbarian Ring me, then they're gonna lose. So they have to put a card in the graveyard, which is likely their Ghost Quarter. Okay, so they should have another Punishing Fire, it looks like. Alright, that's okay. Like, they're dead to a Bolt, and they're at least like 2 or 3 turns off of Merit Liege, which is what's gonna save them here. Barbarian Ring me, right? No, they didn't have another red. Yeah, because they could have Barbarian Ring this, but then they're probably dead to this. Well, they play the Tomb in the main deck. Okay, so I don't have any idea how to sideboard against this deck. I think I probably want a Grudge and K Command for like sphere effects. I want Surgicals for loams and combo pieces. I don't know how good my dazes are on the draw against the lands deck. I want my Edict. Cabal Therapy doesn't seem very good. So I could go something like this, and then look to board out more removal spells. Or maybe I could like cut these spell pierces and then keep in some dazes. Spell pierce doesn't seem super great. I think it's days. Maybe I just want like all the reach. Board out my spell pierces. Nah, the bolts just don't do anything unless they kill my opponent. Alright, I think we're gonna keep the counter magic. My opponent could have whatever the dumb card is. Tireless Tracker, but like, I hope we're gonna be killing them before that really matters. I don't know, at least I'm bringing in the Grudge and the Coloron's Mana, we can help maybe fight my opponent's mana a little bit. Probably gonna like force. Oh, I think I have to mulligan. weird. I don't have like a way to stop like an exploration, and I can't even play my shaman online. It's better. There's no defense, but I actually don't really think this is what we're looking for, and we already have a ponder. The Delver for their entire turn. Next turn, like, they have to have a Grove, and then I can waste them again. Okay, so they're gonna waste me. This is okay. I'm just gonna waste them back, I think. Tabernacle. Oh, I should have forced that. So now I have to hope that they hit the Tabernacle. Drop money, okay. Tabernacle, yeah, I lose. Yeah, so I should have forced that. Yep, definitely should have forced that. I was like, I'm just gonna force what they get. Oh, I need that giveaway. Yep, I was just like, I'm gonna force what they get, and that turned into a Tabernacle. That's frustrating. We could have won that game. We had that game in the bag, actually. Okay, so I want one more daze, and I'll cut if we lose that game, then that's definitely my fault. I would like to play first. Wow. I got to ship this hand. I have force pitch force, but I don't have anything else going on. Yeah. And this hand's like not that great. This hand just like gets smoked by a wasteland. But I think I'm gonna keep it. I can delve my whole graveyard, but then I just get 20/20'd. I can just play like a Delver, then I lose my land, and it just gets Punishing Fired. So I think I'm just gonna pass. Thank you. Everyone's got four cards in their hand. They're Dark Depths. Let's get rid of this right now. And then I could get rid of this too. For $100, do I just shoot this Glacial? This Ghost Quarter? I'm just gonna hope they don't alone. My opponent's alone, I'm in a lot of trouble. They still have the maze though, so that was stupid. They need two threats here to get this maze off the board. And one of my threats just gets punishing fired. Punching fire, maze, Dark Depths, one other card. Alright, well now we're gonna ponder. I'm on here, maze, ponder. I don't think I want any of these cards. I was too aggressive with that first wasteland. But then he just wastelands my wasteland. Or Ghost Quarters my wasteland, then plays maze. This game's tough. But I mean, it's tough because I made it. Not if I could have won game two, and then we wouldn't be here. It was just my mistake. Alright, there's the Dark Depths. So I'm gonna actually just delve. Like my best draw here is actually another angler. Another angler that I'm starting to get around punching fire and Dark Depths. Is that punching fire and maze it? Delver at least gains the first punishing fire. We get two. I think I'm just gonna save this Delver until I draw a until I draw another cantrip or like a surgical. Just because I can gaze the first one, and then if I can get the surgical on this hand, I'm gonna change. Surgical extraction. If I get a surgical extraction here, I might have a chance. Crop rotation. That's not good. Okay. Okay, so now I'm just going to play my Delver. They can go crop rotation to me, but I think that's like this is gonna let them. Like, this is probably gonna cost them. I'm gonna let the first punishing fire resolve. If that's it. Hopefully they go for like punishing fire, or they're just gonna lead off crop rotation. Thank you. That's frustrating because I could have won the second. It's my fault. This is like not a super familiar area. Like I played the match well, but then I was like, okay, I have four with blue card, I'll take care of whatever they gamble. Gamble four. And then they gamble for 10. In that second game, I'm sure that I didn't play. I messed something up. But that was like almost kind of a tough one to come out from. Shaman plus Wasteland. So now I'm probably gonna go play Pyromancer. Yeah, I'm just gonna play the Pyromancer. Then I'm gonna like bolt the Jace, waste him, play Deathrite Shaman. I'm sure that this Alolan deck is kind of a tough matchup for this deck. Doesn't this play like, it plays a bunch of Baleful Strix, plays a bunch of Shardless Agents. So just like a deck that will just outgrind me. Too. So I'm gonna waste. They need double green, so I think I'm actually gonna waste their green source. So I have 4 out of 5 cards in their hand. I think I'm gonna daze this Jace. Because, like, I don't know how long this daze is gonna stay relevant. This bolt's gonna be good for the rest of the game, more than likely. I'm gonna grab some more coffee. I'll be right back. Megatron. So they've got Alluren, they have two Catacombs and an Alluren. I guess I could have saved the days for the Alluren. Because I think I'm in such a bad way that I'm going to use my shaman to scry, or use my fetch line to scry, which is going to be nice, especially if my opponent plays to the battlefield. Yeah. Right, so we're going to eat this. So we have a learn, one and out. And like, if this is effectively game, it deals one more damage because of how this would end up here. Get my land. They play their own Deathrite Shaman and a little puke. So I'm just setting their learn up, right? So I need a discard spell. No, I don't have any discard spells in my main deck. I need a counter spell or a wasteland. Like a wasteland days. Wasteland would be sweet. My opponent locks themselves. So let's see what we got here. Yes, I will reveal a spell pierce. And now we're just off to the races. I wonder how this would have worked had I like played the right line on turn one with my Deathrite Shaman. Like I think I would have, like if I would decay the Shaman, and then I would have had a bunch more we're gonna kill this right now. Well, Lauren doesn't have flash, right? I don't think this deck plays Snapcaster Mage, but like whatever. We're gonna hit the sorcery just to guarantee that we get 2 points in here. We're gonna get out of this. We need to survive. They're up to turn clock as the board sits here. We might get out of this. I guess just kill them, right? Tap them out. Okay. Yeah, this is dead on the board, right? We just go like shaman, attack shaman. Alright, go team. I think they should have played their first alert and then played their next alert. Okay, so on the draw, Angler's probably not great, so you're gonna play a bunch of ways to gum the ground up. I don't really know what else is great. Daze is probably gonna be okay even on the draw, because they're trying to resolve a 4-mana sorcery, but it might be like not as good. It might be 4-ball good, but more than I normally keep it. I want all of my removal. The game goes long. I don't really know how to cycle here. Like, the Pyromancers don't seem as good as they normally are. Like, I kind of want. Then, like, the Edicts are probably kind of meh, because they've got, like, the Elfle Strix running around. If I can kick the Casualties, it should wipe their board. But kicking that's going to be tough. I kind of want to do this. I kind of want to maybe I can trim on a Force or two. But I don't don't know what to bring in. I don't think it's just play a Cabal Therapy against his deck. Though sometimes it's nice to get rid of these cards before they hit the stack. But I think this is just for like common decks. I actually kind of like this against like the green decks, the big green creatures, because they don't bring some cards away. So oftentimes you can track exactly what they have going on. I'm going to go with, because they're trying to resolve a card like a Lauren, the daisies are going to be better than they normally are. Keep all the counter magic, and on the play I might side out two of my forces and bring in like two Cabal Therapies. There, we ship this garbage. Alright, keep this, and I think I'm gonna put this on top. Deathrite Shaman, and I'm gonna hurl. Probably supposed to bottom this because it wasn't an answer, but okay, that's great. We're now gonna get Shaman. Okay, so just gonna play the Delver. Now we got some interaction up here. Kind of card that's going to be super good here. I would assume they don't have a lot of answers to Trinity Nemesis. This deck probably gains a lot of value by just like chumping out, grinding out the board. It's also relevant that Canter Buster Cave because he fetches this island, at least on this turn. But you know, at least it's going to let me hit a third land or find a cantrip. Are they going to pierce this? I think I'm going to spell pierce this. If this is worth them brainstorming here, I kind of want to see what's going on. Like maybe they've got something that's of importance here. I don't know why they would do that, but like, this gives me the opportunity to figure it out, and if it was just a stupid play. They didn't show me their hand. Huh. At least we hit our land for the trainers and snow. That happens. I've been Golgari Charmed out of more games than I care to admit. I think Golgari Charmed is super good in this format. I lose my land for the game, but What else am I doing? I'm just glad that we got the tuning down. And we're just going to turn this thing sideways for like 6 times. And hopefully that gets us there. Carpet flowers. The beginning of each of your main plays, if you haven't added mana to this, add X. Or, okay, so you're going to get 3 more mana a turn. I'm going to hold my layer. That is not tab. So my opponent doesn't have shit going on. These seem very odd to bring it out of this deck. Just like, why are these? You're not playing against, like, I guess this card's okay, but this one seems weird. It's like at this point, you don't even need to use the mana, right? Because you have, I want my Pyroblast to see how many cantrips this deck has and if it has back to basics. So I might side out my forces on the draw or on the play and play Pyroblast. I enjoy playing this deck here, Cavern Heartbeat. Okay, so this lets them not listen, live another turn. Play one life and turn Cavern Heartbeat. Okay, so they can like kinda combo out here. Or is this just it? They're gonna run out of mana, right? PS5, I guess. I always like to see if that was a Maverick player. I've been having a lot of problems with those decks. Alright, so just attack. My opponent's gonna like pathetic beatdown from here, I think. But they only can activate this one time. So yeah, I have problems with those decks. Like I keep playing against them, I don't know how to sideboard. Because like I don't really know how to sideboard against those decks, because whatever, I'm gonna have six to my opponent's turn here. Because like this is what I'm currently like playing here. And I want like this, 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 and this. And like maybe this card. But like my dazes are never very good. Unless I get like a Delver draw on the play. And my forces are like it always feels kind of bad forcing like a Knight of the Reliquary, but I always feel like I have to. You know, like you have a bunch of bad, like not bad cards. I don't want to be mean, but not. But like, you have a bunch of weird, dopey creatures that I feel like I have to get rid of. So what does this do here? They can bounce this one time. So they would like return that one. So they go bounce. They go to four. Bounce this. Go to six. And then these are both untapped. So I'm really gonna hope that my top cards are like. I have one more ball. Something I do like about those big Maverick decks is that because I play seven duels, and I've seen the decks been moving towards, I feel like I have more game. Because I don't get to get wastelanded out of the game. Okay, so it returns this, digs me for two. To a lightning bolt, I would be a happy camper. Let me bolt. Flip to lightning bolt, brainstorm. Okay. Flying. So they just go block, return this, attack me for two, so I'm just like dead here. I have no outs, so I can't find like land lightning bolt. Alright, let's see if they do it. I'm fairly sure I'm dead here. This is gonna go block. Return Cabin Harpy. This is maybe this Carbon Flower is actually not too bad for my opponent. It seems odd that the Hymn to Turak Alluring deck plays back to basics on their sideboard. I lose to this card a lot. I've noticed. I just lost the match to lands I should have won. I was sitting with Force plus Blue card. My opponent's dead next turn. And they go, whatever it is. They go to play, I go to gamble, and I'm like, I don't have any lands in play, because it wastelanded me out, but I have 2-foot Delvers. And I go to, like, I force blue card, that's it. And my opponent goes gamble, and I'm like, oh, sure. And I'll force whatever they play, and they got a tabernacle. I was like, yep. Can't be doing that. Okay. So I kind of want these pyroblasts, because I see there's so many blue creatures that it kills. This card's just like shenanigans. I guess Diabolic Edict is relevant as long as they don't have a Baleful Strix in play. Alright, let's go with this. Well, the Last Hope seems pretty good. It's just like a creature interactor. Yeah, we're gonna go like this. The Spell Pierces seem kind of egregious. I do like playing this deck. This deck's right up my alley. It's aggressive and it's disruptive. I think I'm gonna keep this. I get a whole bunch of looks at a red land, and I can leave with a Delver. I'll kill their Deathrite Shaman. Their hand sucks. Alright, that's a sick draw. I think I'm still gonna probe one more time, because if I can hit a Shaman, I'll play it. I should use this daze, or if I should use this fork bowl on the shaman instead. I think I'm going to use the fork bowl on the shaman and then look to daze the hand, especially considering they do a basic land right there. So now they're going to be able to hit me. Yeah, so we're just going to let fork bowl, ponder, and then daze the hand. Their next however many relevant plays. God, trying to resolve a 4-mana enchantment at sorcery speed just seems like so vomit inducing. I'm gonna pick up my vault. This is actually nice because it's another card in my hand to brainstorm. Though the card underneath the brainstorm is not good, so I think I'm going to draw the brainstorm, fetch, and ponder. Looking for like a deathrite shot. This kills this next turn, so we're just gonna stay. this Cavern Harpy. This Cavern Harpy doesn't work with Baleful Strix. It's gonna be annoying if they can land this Leovold though. They played around Days last turn, so. Something else is not. Hopefully they play either like Cavern Harpy or Alluring. Because if they go Cavern Harpy, bounce this, then I can daze this. And then I can wasteland them and be off to the races. Get another token. And then I can clear their board and attack them for 3, 5, 6, 7. And then put them on 2-turn clock. I feel like they can't. They should just play the label, I think. So they have Cavern Harpy or left. So I think I have to dismember this label and then attack. Two elementals, and then like wasteland this bayou. I shouldn't always yield this. I'm in a tough spot. We're just getting like ground out here. Nice thing is like their hands, their deck's very clunky. I'm just gonna waste this body. And then just attack with an elemental. I would like to just waste this Baleful Strix, or hit this Baleful Strix and start attacking, but then they draw a card off the wasteland as well. This game is like slowly, like slipping out. They brainstorm now. Unless they're setting up a Shardless Agent or if they have a Force of Will. They force their deck too. Something I'm gonna hit this by. Cut small double green. And him. Nice part here is my opponent doesn't have a land and they just go like cascade. Then I can put this into the land. So you have a Luring, Cavern Harpy, and a bunch of cards that don't know. Then they go Cavern Harpy, bounce the Baleful Strix. And they play Baleful Strix, I daze it. And I've got 3, 5, 8, 10, 12 showing. So I can't. And like if this, I'm assuming if this Lauren resolves, then I'm pretty dead. But I'm not sure. Shipping him with Pyromancer as well. I attack with everything, they take 5, and then they're dead next turn to the Shaman activation. And then they can't Cavern Harpy also, if they just take it. So I think I'm just going to attack with everything. Because if they just take this, and they can't Cavern Harpy anything, unless they play the combo piece first. And they're still dead next turn. So I'm gonna hold my land. I guess I should have played it because then if I hit another, if I hit Forceful, I can like cast it. Alright, that's good enough. So now I need land, Alluren, and like a bunch of other cards in order to kill me. It's been a fun game. Alright, let's see. I do enjoy playing this deck a lot. I'm gonna go grab some more coffee. Look to get paired here. I was watching a stream one time and I saw an Alluren player play against a show and tell player, and the Alluren player goes like show and tell in, you know, whatever, and the Alluren player show and tells in Alluren, and he just wins with like the trigger, he wins with, you know, Emrakul in play on his opponent's turn. I was like, that's so sweet. Played like a recruit of the card, when you got the piece he needed, and it just like bounced. That I could play Shaman off of so that I could save my fetch land and brainstorm, because I'm gonna need some removal. I'm gonna guess this is actually kind of a tough matchup. See one of my cards be bad, and all my cards in the hand are kind of turned on at this point, so I'm gonna fetch. I don't really want to see a bad card, and if I get Brainstorm locked, I'm gonna get Brainstorm locked. I'm gonna go off of this because this is making Lightning Bolt. Okay, now we're off of this. Let's put this back, this back. I think I'm gonna take one more shot. Okay, they're just gonna. Wow, that seems odd. And now we're just gonna chill out. Okay, draw land. That makes sense. So this is probably gonna be a tough matchup in general, but I think Pyromancer is like our way to steal it. Okay, yeah, let's scoop it up. And then mulligan to four, so like we beat a deck that mulligans to four, which is always great. Okay, so I want Edict, Command, Pyroblast kills Meddling Mage, and they might have like more blue. Like, I don't know if they're gonna play Mantis Rider, but they might play like Phantasmal Image. So let's see, Pyroblast there maybe. Missing Marsh Casualties. Cards I'm not really interested in. On the draw, I'm not interested in Days. I'm not really interested in these routes, so. Give me a second here. Still recording, so the YouTube video will be intact. Alright, there we go. So we're back here. Alright, we're good. Say this is an angler, but it does, and it's got a wasteland, but it doesn't have any removal. We have a ponder. I guess I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna fight to get. Like, I might just waste this. I'm gonna probe first. For a turn or two. Probably not gonna attack this. I'm gonna do this. I think I'm just gonna keep. So I did have Phantasmal Mage, so I'm glad that we brought in. And it kills Pyroblast as well. It kills Reflector Mage. Is no good anymore. I can't think. So like, I'm gonna shuffle away this Marsh Casualties. I wonder if it's worth bringing a card like Cabal Therapy in this matchup. I'm gonna definitely just take my Ponder, I think. So you're just gonna play Thalia's Lieutenant or Phantasmal Image. You just wanna make sure that like, I don't find removal. Thank you. Oh, the mom protects it, so yeah, we're just like super in trouble now. We're just like super dead, right? Because like the mom protects everything. And they're gonna just like damage target this. Now that I can't. Maybe I should have just been developing, not wasting them. We might wasteland a canopy later in the game. If we find a way to deal with Mirror Crusader, we're in good shape. I might need to roll down my Liliana in order to clear these top two cards. These are not very good, and I'm running out of red mana. So I basically have to like... No, this is actually okay. So I'm gonna wasteland them. Cabal Therapy and Mirror Crusader. I should have probably just gonna like bolt on a phone guy. So I know my top cards are like one, so I might as well just like hold here. So I'm not doing anything. Have a deathmatch on activation map. And then just steal a game behind this Liliana. I'm worried about like a flicker wisp, I guess. I got Phyrexian for a red. Just check out on this. We should be in good shape now. I don't think they have any haste. I'm gonna just therapy the phantasmal image. I don't see, because this doesn't kill me. Something like this might kill me. No, I guess. I'll get rid of that. Then I'll just pass and like play around. Play around like Mirror Strider off the top. I don't know if this version plays it, but. Going for the 3-2 after we woke up and knocked off the cobwebs. We're gonna see if we can catch back up. Should have won this match. Wish that was a mistake on my end. I should have won that. Snapcaster, it's like something sweet to like ditch with Cabal Therapy. And these spell piercers are just so gross. I could either play like a Snapcaster Rage or like another Cold Out Scream, like one of the main one wards. I feel like I bring this card all the time. Nice that we're gonna be able to look at our opponent and see what they're doing before we figure out if we need to like cantrip into interaction or play Delver. Okay. Force is great. So now I'm basically just gonna play. I guess I would play a Shaman if I drew it. So let's probe. Like maybe he's like, oh, I get the free win, but like I don't think that you should be doing that. So that's such a weak brainstorm. that seems like a really weak brainstorm. Definitely raising a Baleful Strix. And I think I'm just going to... I don't think I'm going to brainstorm. I think I need like a full... It's my blue card to pitch, which I need to... Yeah, I need to counter, like, I can deal with Leovold, even though that's annoying. The Tune Nemesis is, like, the huge problem. So we don't want to get wastelanded. Next turn, I can go, like, a good brainstorm, and then we have a nice card to pitch to force. I feel like we're in kind of good shape here. Like, we're in better shape than we should be. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so we're gonna attack. Pondo's a good draw. What am I looking for? I'm looking for another threat. So I think I'm gonna brainstorm my main phase. Alright, I don't want any of these lands, so I'm gonna put both of these back. And there's nothing, so I haven't played, I played a land this turn, so like, there's no sense in pondering now. I might as well give myself like the most chances for something to occur here, or like give myself more information. Swear Shaman. We're gonna spell curse this. They probably take my ponder. Well, they should take ponder because if they draw an abrupt decay, they should take bolt. Okay. I think they should take a ponder because if they draw a way to cast abrupt decay, and, like my whole world comes crashing down. So what am I forcing? I'm not forcing anything because like the only card that matters is True Name Nemesis, and I'm like far enough ahead of that. Actually, they were just dead. Alright, I might as well take a spell pierce. Or I can just go double shaman. Which double shaman sounds great. You are dead 6 ways to send out your friend. And now they can't cry to fetch land. They have to kill. They can't cry to fetch land, so okay, they're forcing this. They pitch Leovold. Okay, so they're dead. They don't have a draw. Nice. Okay, so on the draw, I'm going to cut all my gauges. Look at my spell pierces. I think the things that matter the most are creatures. So let's go. We want this Kolaghan's Command. We want these two Power Blasts. On an Edict. I want my Dismember. I want my Last Hope. I don't want all of my forces. So I could cut like 2 forces for a Flusterstorm and a Marsh Casualties. I think you do want like, I think I haven't played this deck very much, but what I have played is like people make big mistakes where they decide to like cut all of their forces, I think, in all these fair matchups. And it's like, why do you want to play into the fair deck's plans? You know, because like, I don't want to play a long game. I just want to like force the one card that matters. Like, I don't want to play a long game. Like, I could cut a land maybe and then keep another force. I don't know. always think that's just like a philosophical huge mistake that a lot of people make. They're just like, I'm cutting all my forces. And I'm like, well, aren't you playing into the long game of your opponent by doing that? I think I'm favored in this matchup if I can keep a shaman on the board. Like, I think this matchup just matters that much. It's all about, like, death rate, shaman, superiority. It's like, who shamans harder? Okay, so him. They can't hit me, but they're gonna cast Baleful Strix next turn. I like all these cards. I think I like the Brainstorm the least, and I like the Edict the most. So we're gonna protect the Edict from him. Oh man, that's such a weak Brainstorm. It's like, what's my opponent worried about? Like, why are they in a hurry? You know? Edict also flips my Delver, which is nice. This seems like such a poor play. There's the Bayou. Him, you got it. You have my True Name and my Angler? Gross. Alright, now I want my Brainstorm more than ever. What a beating. If they go to play like whatever it is here, Baleful Strix. Nice. So I can go like Edict targeting you and then Wasteland. Sometimes him just gets you. I played in one Legacy SCG and I top 64'd it because I played him. I kept playing Buck Delver and I himmed my opponents just out of the game. Yep, here goes the decay. And now we're kind of ground out. I'm going to waste this Bayou. Oh, no, no. twice the underground scene now. Take these cards in my hand to get hemmed. I only have one blue source, so I can't like snap cast it. I'm tempted to have more spell piercers in my deck after seeing the Lilanas. Listen, like, to hell with this part, right? So you're gonna bring one more force in. The bolts are good, the pyroblasts are good, the cantrips are good. I'm gonna take a Buster Strike. Buster Strike seems worse than Force when all the cards that matter are like creatures and planeswalkers. Creatures planeswalkers are good, so Buster Strike does hit. But like, I really like it doesn't hit the cards that really matter. So it'll be really dominating. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, underground scene. Or bogus. Playing for all the marbles here. Turn next turn. I'm gonna go like Wasteland, hold up Pyroblast, don't go to the dude. Come on. Go dirt. I still think I'm gonna ponder and Wasteland. Yeah, definitely do that. Ponder first. Just get a little more information. I don't think I want any of these. It's a good draw. The way my opponent gets back into this game is like Deathrite Shaman, so I'm gonna go like, they go land Deathrite Shaman, and go like, bolt Wasteland. Alright, this is where you get this big old dick punching match here. I will punch harder. Alright, all of these are pretty good. The Angler's actually, no, actually none of these are good. Blast this Strix. Yeah, this means that this Liliana Last Hope is going to come down, which is going to be tough. So I need to get on the board here. Thank you. fetched around Wasteland, and we drew Wastelands, which has been tough. OBS is having a tough time this morning. And yeah, we just pass. We needed a threat there to play into this early on, I think. We needed like an angler. Or a... I needed a Gurmag angler or not playing it. Okay, let's jump back to the deck. So we've gone 3-2 in this league had I not punted this much. That was my fault, just not knowing. So let's go.